Hello everybody, and this is the Persia Let's Play for Civilization 4 on Horizon Falls of Civilization. And this, I'm just skipping over the loading screen there. You'll notice it is in something like double speed, so everything goes a lot faster, obviously. It also means I don't have the sound, but hopefully you'll be able to see everything clearly over here. And now, it's important to get that horse up there, so I usually build a city up north, take over the Babylonians quickly, as well as the Indians, before they start getting iron and things like that to defend themselves properly. And you want to get the horses yourself before, so you can start getting more mortals, because you start losing them quickly if you do it. Got India, got Babylon, first few turns. That's what you need to do. And that was a bit stupid up there, but oh well. And then you wanna want to go and get Egypt. Obviously it is historically inaccurate to have gone and gotten India, but it is required, and later on I go far further than the Persians ever did. There we go, we've got Egypt. And we'll start using mercenaries now that we've got heaps of monies from taking over all this land so quickly. Ivory to get some elephants later on. Persians did get some of India, but not Delhi, I believe. Start building some wonders. Sometimes getting 8% of the world's territory is not the hardest part of the UHV, but rather it's actually getting the holy cities, because you don't always get the two priests, great prophets that you want. Spearmen are a problem at this point. I don't know if I can see that right. It says 230 BC, which is nowhere near when the Persians really were around. Kind of makes no sense at all. Maybe it says 730, I don't know. Not gonna take you. Ethiopia, so we may as well get a vassal. There we go, we got Athenae. And still not quite getting that 13%, and so I ended up deciding to go a little bit further. Great Wall of Persia. Fortunately, Persia had the special ability to gain stability points from taking cities, so that means you're not going to collapse when you do this. You might later on, not straight away. And here comes the plague, yay! Troops out of there. There's one holy shrine, 90 AD. Yes, I don't think any Persians have ever got this far. you do take this area, it can be a problem where you start finding that barbarians are coming, and I'm finding a problem that I'm losing too much money, and so I'm going to start losing troops as well. And that is a small problem. And I'm on 7%. I'm not sure why I was continuing to delete all those troops. Library for culture, get some more land. Yes, that was a little bit hopeful there. There might be some weak cities, but no. There's my second shrine. I think it's 600 AD when you need these by. I'm not sure though, can't remember. I'll see you soon. Bad. Oh, that's what I was trying to do. Trying to get some more technology space so I could get music and then expand my borders. Wonder where I intended to do it. Great artist. Japanese. quite dependent on slavery, I think, in this game, I was. Yes, yeah, certainly looking for culture. Got my great artist, and I was intending to put him in. See. And the Japanese declare war on me. Interesting. And I don't know why I did it there. There you go. 8% of the world's territory. 2 holy shrines. Now I just need something else. Probably just to wait. And here comes Arabia. Wonderful. Second great artist. There we go. You can pause this point at any point. Yeah, it's quite a big empire, that one. Persia, that's a fun one. Hope this gave you a decent, walkthrough.